Hello, everybody, and welcome to today's event, which is Making Gogatsu Ningyo, Doll Making Demonstration and Talk by Goshiki's Hara Hiroko from Japan House, London. My name is Simon Wright, and I am the Director of Programming. Welcome, everybody. So for all of those people watching, please note that your microphone and webcam will be disabled for the entire duration of the event. Please use the question and answer feature to type your questions for the presenters at any time throughout the session. And if you don't want your name to be written down, you can please check the option send anonymously. Questions will be collected by Japan House moderators, and a selection will be answered live at the end of the event. We hope that we'll be able to answer as many as possible, but please do send your questions through at any time during the session. Please note that the contents of this event will be streamed live on Facebook, YouTube, and LinkedIn, where a recording will be archived later. So today, this event is live from London, from Japan House London, and also from Tokyo and from Asakusa, in fact, where we are joined by Hara Hiroko, who is a doll maker. Thank you very much indeed, Hara-san, for joining us. Of course, this event is in the anticipation of tomorrow's Children's Day, when dolls and model suits of warrior armor are set out for any boys who may be in a family. The girls, of course, have their own festival on the 3rd of March, but tomorrow's festival has become Children's Day, celebrating all children. So Hara-san, thank you very much for joining us. You are the third generation doll maker of the specialist doll manufacturer Goshiki. And since its founding in Asakusa-bashi in Tokyo more than 100 years ago, Goshiki has been producing and selling dolls for Japanese festival celebrations, including Gogatsu Ningyo for Tango no Sekku, which is tomorrow, of course, and Hina dolls for Hinamatsuri, which is on the 3rd of March. And from early childhood, Hara-san was trained in doll making by her grandfather, the founder of Goshiki, Harabeishu. And after graduating from Joshibi University of Art and Design, she studied art, interior design and fashion in the United Kingdom. So thank you very much for joining us again after your time in London all those years ago and again back now. Thank you very much. After your studies in the UK, you resumed your doll training, doll making training under your mother, Hara Koshu. And in 2018, Hara-san became officially recognized as Goshiki's third generation doll maker. Thank you very much indeed, Hara-san. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for having me today. I'm very honored.
It's an absolute pleasure. Thank you so much. And today, Hara-san will give a presentation, first of all, and then there will be a demonstration of how the dolls are made. And also, Eya Kurosawa will be with us, who will help as an interpreter for the duration of the event, for the presentation, the demonstration, and for the question and answers at the end. Hara-san, may I hand over to you, and I will leave you to give your presentation, and we will see you a little bit later on. Thank you. Thank you very much.
それでは、ご説明させていただきます。
Thank you. 本日は、I shall begin. Thank you.
本日は5月4日でございますが、明日5月5日は日本では子どもの日という祝日です。
Today is 4th of May, and tomorrow, 5th of May, is Children's Day in Japan, which is a national holiday.
現在日本では子どものための祝日が2日あります。女の子は3月3日、男の子が5月5日です。
There are two nationally celebrated days for children in Japan, 3rd of March for girls and 5th of May for boys.
具体的に何をするのかと申しますと、赤ちゃんが生まれると女の子の場合は3月3日に、男の子の場合は5月5日にお人形を飾り、赤ちゃんの誕生や子どもの健やかな成長を祝います。
On these two dates, Japanese households display dolls to wish for healthy growth and good fortune for the newborns and children. Girls' parents display dolls on the 3rd of March and boys, 5th of May.
もともと日本ではこの2日間に限らず、古代から出産の時や幼児のためにお人形を飾る習慣がありました。お人形が幼児の身代わりとなり、魔を払うと信じられていたためです。
In ancient times, there were customs to display dolls for childbirth as well as for children, which weren't limited to these two dates. Dolls were believed to ward off evil spirits to protect children.
こちらのお写真の人形は、現在の上皇様がお生まれになった時に、祖父が制作して献上した天月と呼ばれるお人形になります。
The doll displayed here is called Amagatsu, which my father made at the birth of the Emperor Emeritus as a gift to the Imperial House.
とても形は簡素ですが、少なくとも1300年ほど前の平安時代からお守りとして飾られてきたものです。
The shape itself is very simple, but it has a tradition of more than 1,300 years, at least from the Heian era, as a guardian doll.
このように赤ちゃんの無病息災を願い、お人形を飾る習慣が長い歴史の中でその他の習慣と一緒になり、やがて体系化され、3月3日と5月5日に集約されていきました。
These customs of displaying dolls for wish, to wish for good health and fortune for children were organized, as well as with other customs, to be national celebrations on 3rd of March and 5th of May.
この祝日が体系化される経緯から、現在は2つの子どもの日に飾るお人形には異なる特徴がございます。
Before these organizations, these two celebrations had different characteristics due to its long history.
こちらのお写真は、3月3日の女の子の日に飾る男女一対の雅なひな人形になります。
The picture on this slide shows the dolls displayed on 3rd of March, which are called Hina dolls, which has a couple of dolls and with a male and female figure, which are displayed both at the same time.
こちらは、男の子の日に飾る、写真の向かって左側が神の力が宿る神聖な甲冑。お写真の右側がお人形になります。
And for boys, these two sets are displayed. On the left-hand side, you will see the sacred warrior armors, which were believed to hold sacred power. And on the right, you see the dolls for the boys' day.
それでは、5月5日に飾るお人形の制作工程についてお話をしていきます。
From now, I will explain the doll's making, which is to be displayed on Children's Day, 5th of May.
お人形はそれぞれのパーツごとに専門の職人がすべて手作業で制作します。
And the dolls are made completely by hand, and each parts are made by specialized artisans.
大きく分けると頭部と胴体に分けられますので、まずは頭部からご説明していきます。
The parts could roughly be divided into two parts, the head, kashira, and 胴体, the torso. So, I will explain from the kashira, head.
Kashira の部分は、まずは粘土で原型を作り、写真のようなシリコン型を作成します。
For the head, We first make a prototype with clay, and make the mold, and as you see in this picture.
そのシリコンの型に石膏を流し込み、固め、乾燥させます。
The mold is made from silicone, and we pour over the plaster, to make the base of the head. The head made with the plaster is dried and applied with the gofun, which is the powdered seashells, and gelatin is mixed together, and we apply it smoothly.
マットで美しい真っ白な肌をそして作ります。
To create the white and porcelain skin.
次に、胡粉を塗った頭に一つ一つ手書きでお顔の造作を書き込んでいきます。
Next, we paint in the face. This process is called menso. On the head, which is painted with 胡粉。
この工程は面相と呼ばれます。面相筆と呼ばれる1ミリほどの極細のほど筆で髪の生え際、眉、目、口を描きます。
This process is called 面相, and using the fine point 面相 brush, we paint in the hairline, eyebrows, and the eyes.
何本も何本も細い線を描き、重ね描いていきます。この技法は大変難しく、現在描ける職人は数人しかおりません。
The face is painted by repeating layering the ink finely, and this process is extremely difficult, so there aren't many craftsmen who could paint in the face.
面相が終わると次は髪の毛です。黒く染めた絹糸を貼り付けていく結髪と呼ばれる作業になります。
Once the menso is completed, now we move on to 結髪, which is hairdressing. We plant, the process is implanting the silk thread, a dyed silk thread onto the head.
黒く染色したスガと呼ばれる絹糸に糊をつけ、頭部にまんべんなく貼っていきます。
These black dyed silk thread is called suga, and glue is applied at the tip of the silk thread, evenly.
さらに髪の生え際に彫られた溝にも植え込み。
And the hair is applied in to be in line with the hairline which has been painted.
たっぷりと豊かな髪で結い上げます。
To create the thick, black hair to make it into various hairstyles.
次に胴体部分に移ります。
Next, we move on to making the torso.
お人形の胴体はこのお写真のような霧の木の粉で作られています。
And the torso, body of the dolls, are made with the powdered polonia tree, as you see in this picture.
霧の木の粉に糊を混ぜ、粘土状にしたものを型に入れ成形します。しっかりと乾燥させ、その後表面に胡粉を塗り、さらに溝を掘ります。
We make the clay-like textured material by mixing the glue and polonia tree and powder to make the body. And we apply the 胡粉 and powder on top of this body andthen mark the lines afterwards.
お写真の向かって左が乾燥後の胴体で、 向かって右が胡粉を塗り溝を掘ったものです。
On the picture, one on the left is the body, that's after that's been made into in the mold and been dried. And on the right, 胡粉 powder is applied on top.
この溝は着物の縫い目や動きに合わせて掘られており、この溝に布を押し込み、お人形に着物を着せる決め込みの作業に移ります。
These lines are marked with knife, and to accentuate the kimono seams and movements of the body, the cloth are pushed and tucked into these lines to make the appearance of kimono.
この作業は後ほど実演でお見せいたします。
This process I will show you at a workshop as a demonstration.
Dōtai ni kiseru kimono wa utsukushiku senshoku shita kinu ito kyoto de otta mono desu.
And the kimono to dress these bodies have been made with the fabric that's beautifully dyed silk threads which has been woven by a textile manufacturer in Kyoto.
人間が実際に着る着物と同じように美しく織られていますが、柄の大きさなどはお人形に合わせて小さく縮小してあります。
And these fabric has been made the same way as the human-sized kimonos. However, the patterns have been scaled down to create this a suitable design for the dolls.
たくさんの着物の布地の中からお人形に合う布を選び、その布を小さく裁断し、お人形に着せていきます。
The kimono is chosen individually for the dolls, considering each individual characteristics and for the size, to be the perfect size for them.
それでは、先ほど申し上げた通り、決め込みを実際にこれから少しお見せしたいと思います。
Now, as I have just mentioned, I will show you the process of a 決め込み from now.
Thank you very much, Hara-san. Wonderful. Thank you so much for that beautiful presentation. Your dolls are so beautiful. I've got lots of questions already, but I know now that you're going to move over to...the other part of your studio where you will give us a live demonstration of this particular method of creating dolls. We're going to change cameras. There we go. Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you very much. Okay, thank you, Hara-san. I will hand over to you and speak to you a little bit later on. Thank you so much.
こちらが先ほどお写真でお見せした霧の木の粉を固めたものです。
This is the one that I have shown you in the picture. The body that's made with the Polonia sawdust and thus it has been dried and it's in shape.
そしてこちらがそれに胡粉を塗り溝を掘ったものになります。
And this body has been painted with the 胡粉 powder and marked with the lines have been marked.
それでは、その胡粉を塗ったものに途中まで決め込みを施したものに。これからこちらの部分にこの布を決め込んでいきたいと思います。
And today I will show you the 決め込みof this part. This body has already started the 決め込み process for this body has already been started. So I will continue on to show you the process on this part.
いらない部分を切り取ります。
So the unnecessary part is cut out.
そしてこの溝の部分に糊をつけていきます。
I apply the glue in the line that has already been marked and cut.
そしてこの糊のついた溝にぐっと布を押し込んでいきます。
And I push in the cloth in these, lines which is filled with glue.
それでは次にこちらの部分に移ります。
Next, we work on the top part.
まず、まだ糊を入れてない溝に布をちょっと押し込みます。
The first step is to push in the cloth before I apply the glue.
そしてまた余っているパートを切り取ります。
Again, I cut the unnecessary cloth, here.
そして先ほどと同じように溝に糊を入れていきます。
As with the previous part, I apply the glue in the lines.
そして布のついた溝にまた布を押し込んでいきます。
And using the already pushed in parts, as the guide, I tuck in the parts, into the lines where the glue has been applied.
そしたらば今度はこちら側に移ります。
Next, we move on to the side.
また同じように糊のついてない溝に最初布を押し込みます。
Again, I'm pushing in the cloth, where the lines haven't been glued yet.
そして余分な部分を切り取り、
And the unnecessary part, is cut again.
またこの溝に糊を入れていきます。
And apply the glue into the line again.
では最後の部分に移ります。
And now we're on to the last part.
また同じように溝に布を押し込みます。
And we're pushing the cloth into the last line as we did into the other lines.
余分な部分を切り取ります。
And I cut the excess cloth again.
そしてまたこの溝に糊を入れていきます。
And again, the glue is applied into the line.
こうやって、すべての面を決め込んでいくと完成していきます。
And as you saw, and this process is repeated on the, onto the old all the sections, and once all the surfaces are covered with cloth, and that's when the doll is complete.
それでこちらに、すべて決め込みが終わり、
And this doll, the 決め込み process, has been finished, for this doll already.
手や足などを取り付けたものがこちらにあります。
And both hands and foot, feet has been applied, so this is the completed doll.
そして、紙付けもお顔も全部完成した頭を取り付けていきます。
Once the head is applied, the body and the doll is completed.
そして出来上がります。
And now we have the Gogatsu Ningyo.
はい、ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much. Thank you, Hara-san. That's amazing. Thank you so much. So now Hara-san, I know we'll move once again to where she was before. And we have some questions from the people who've been watching. I have some questions as well, so we'll see. And I wonder if we can also maybe get Hara-san to show us a little bit else of what's in her studio. So Hara-san, have you managed to move? Yes, you have. Thank you so much. Hello. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
That was done so skillfully and so quickly as well. I can see. This is my question is, I suppose, this is called this particular process is called kumikomu. Yes, is that correct? The name of the doll?
はい、決め込みです。
決め込み。
はい。
Exactly. Yeah, 決め込み。
決め込み、what's the difference between this particular kind of doll, 決め込み, and other dolls?
一般的な、お人形には2種類がありまして、実際にお着物を着せているタイプのもの、縫った、お着物を着せているタイプと、今回のように溝を掘って直接つけていってしまうものと2種類あります。
So there are two types of dolls and with Gogatsu Ningyo. The first is the one that wears the actually woven and sewn up kimono. And the second is the kimekomi ningyo, which is the type that I've shown you. The one that has the cloth is pasted on into the lines that have been marked.
Okay, thank you very much. And I noticed you used Polonia sawdust, Polonia wood. Is there a particular reason for using Polonia wood?
はい、もともとは粉ではなく霧の木を直接掘って作っていたんです。
Originally, yes, there is a reason why the Polonia wood is used. Originally, the sawdust wasn't used. It was the actual polonia tree was curved over and to make the doll.
で、霧の木を使っていた理由としては、硬すぎず柔らかすぎず、で、細かい造作にも耐えられるように目が詰まっているので、お人形が制作しやすかったために霧の木を使っていました。
And polonia tree is not too hard, not too soft. The perfect, the texture is almost perfect for doll making, and it's dense as well. So it's easy to curve out very detailed dolls as well. So that's why polonia tree was favored.
ですが、霧の木のをいくら使いやすいとは言っても、一つ一つ掘っているのでは数を作ることができないので、数をたくさん作るために。粉にして粘土状にして作るという方法に移っていきました。
However, even though the texture is optimal for dolls making, if we were curving out every single dolls, we won't be able to make that many of them. Therefore, the dolls making the craftsmen have decided to use the sawdust in the process of it.And it was mixed in with the glue to create the shape of the dolls.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. So we have a question here from somebody, Melanie Chatfield has written in and asked, what are the traditions of the designs? How are the designs recorded and handed down of the dolls?
はい、5月の5日にお飾りするお人形というのは ですね、もともと5月の5日というのは日本での旧暦なので、今でいう6月の半ば頃、梅雨の季節になるんですね。
Yes, sure. So just to explain, the dolls that are displayed, that I have shown you is displayed to be displayed on 5th of May. But this 5th of May is based on the lunar calendar. Therefore, in the actual solar calendar that we use now, Gregory calendar, it would be on around middle of June.
で、日本ではその時には、梅雨に当たりますので、その時に、病気だったりとかにならないようにこう香りが強い夜光の高い菖蒲を飾ったり身につけたりしていたんです。
And the middle of June in Japan is in the middle of rainy season. Therefore, to protect our health and to make sure that we don't contract anyIllnesses, a lot of herbs were used. For example, shobu, which is a popular one that is still used today, people were carrying it around them or dressing the shobu.
で、そのショウブというこの同じ音が、武士道を大切にするという武を尊ぶという勝負という言葉と同じ音だったために、武士の世界になるとその男の子のお祝いというのをするものにこう徐々に変わっていくんですね。その勝負が同じ音の勝負の意味をもっと強調するようになっていったんです。
And the shobu plant had the same same tone, same sound as the shobu, which sounds the same as respecting the samurai spirit. Therefore, it was favored that's why this date became the date to celebrate the growth of boys and healthy growth of children.
で、武士のお家になると後継ぎだったりとかその男の子にが大切だったものですからその流れで、鎧とお人形を飾るようになってでまたそれがくっついてお人形が鎧を着たり兜をかぶったりする形に変化していきます。
And in the samurai family households, it was extremely important for boys to carry on the strength of the samurai spirits, which was required. Therefore, they decided to display the doll and armors and the samurai wares. And that's why the dolls have the similar type of hairdos and the kimono, the dressings, which is related to the samurai traditions.
Of course, thank you. Thank you, Hara-san. Of course, shobu is a kind of iris, yes, and that grows at this time of year. So I noticed in your last slide, when you showed a completed doll, there was an iris, I believe, on the side. Thank you very much for that. Thank you for the question. We also have...some questions about the process now, actually, if I may. We have a question from Marion McCrindle, who is asking, what could you tell us again about the powder that covers the body after the Polonia sawdust is? What is the name of this powder?
Hi.はい、貝殻の、粉にしたもので作られています。で、日本ではお人形だけではなく、日本画にも使われていて、白い色の絵の具として使われています。
Yes, Goffin is made with seashells. It's broken seashells, powdered seashells, and they are used for the traditional Japanese paintings, 日本画 too.
So it's gofun, yes? Is that right?
はい、gofun です。
gofun, okay. Thank you very much.
Yes, it's called gofun.
And another question we have, this is from Margaret Jennings. It's about how is the glue?
マーガレットさんからです。あの、のりはどのようにして作られているんでしょうか？
And does the doll have to be kept within a certain temperature range or other conditions?
はい。主に使われる糊に関しては、でんぷんを主成分にしています。植物性のでんぷんなので、今は、タピオカの粉がメインで使われていることが多いですね。
Yes, the glue is mainly made with starch, plant-based starch. So, at the moment, we mainly use tapioca flour.
Thank you. And I have another question about the glue as well. This is from Ulrika Hutchins. Can you confirm that the glue is only ever applied in the line and not under all of the fabric pieces?
はい、そうなんです。面には糊をつけませんというのは、着物に糊のシミが出てきてしまうので、溝にしか入れません。
Yes, that's right. Glue is only ever applied in the lines because if you apply the glue onto the surface, then the stain will show up in the kimono, so we don't apply the glue on the surface.
それから先ほどの、ご質問の中にお人形のいい温度のご質問があったと思うんですが、お人形のそのにできているのがその霧の木の粉ということもあるので、あまり湿度が高かったりするとやはりカビの原因になったりとかするので、湿度はあまり高くなく、それからそうですね、温度はさほど影響はしませんが、やはり高すぎない方がいいと思います。
Yes, and I believe there was a question about temperature, good temperature for the dolls. It's because the dolls are made with polonia trees, so sawdust of polonia trees. So I believe the temperature itself is not so problematic, but the humidity is. Therefore, you have to be careful with not to store it in highly humid conditions.
Okay, thank you very much. I'm looking at all the questions that are coming in now. I can see people are definitely interested. One question is about, do men and women traditionally make dolls? And to add that, who taught your grandfather to make dolls?
はい、そうですね、今はやはり男性の方が多いですかね。女性の人形師はそんなに多くないと思います。
Yes, there are more male doll makers now as well. There aren't that many female doll makers.
で、祖父の先生は、沢栗長五郎先生という方で、とても有名な、人形師の方でした。
And the master of my grandfather was called 沢栗長五郎. He was a very well-known dolls maker.
Where was he from?
どちらの出身でしたか？
沢栗先生のちょっと出身はわからないんですが、祖父は東京でその沢栗先生のお宅にお世話になっておりましたので、東京の方だと思います。
I see.
Yes, I'm not exactly sure of where 沢栗sensei is from, but my grandfather learned the skills from 沢栗先生 in Tokyo, so I believe he was based in Tokyo.
Okay, wonderful. Thank you very much indeed. I'm going to be a bit cheeky, if I may, Hara-san. Is it possible to see some of the dolls in your studio? I know you have some very beautiful displays.
あ、はい。じゃあ、カメラ切り替えた方がよろしいですか?
yes, sure. And maybe it's better if I switch to another camera.
できる?
In the meantime, thank you.
そこの飾ってあるお人形をゆっくりと。
There we go. Thank you. Exactly. So wonderful. As we watch these, I think. Thank you very much, Haru-san. One question is, who are your customers?
ですね。先ほど申し上げた通り、お子様がお生まれになった時に買うお人形なので、赤ちゃんが生まれたご両親が多いです。
As I explained in my presentations, a lot of the parents seek out to buy dolls once they have children, newborns. So young parents tend to be my customers.
Okay, and now we're looking at Hina dolls, aren't we? From March.
Just much.
So this, hi.
Yes, exactly.
Are there? Can customers choose what kind of pattern or of clothes or is it the doll maker's choice? How are the clothes chosen, for example?
ですね、それは、出来上がるまでにとてもお時間のかかるものなので、私の方でお選びしたものを販売しています。
It takes a lot of time to make these dolls, so I tend to choose them before they are being sold to the customers.
Thank you. And is there any tradition about how they are displayed?
そうですね。3月3日のその女の子の場合は、男の子と女の子の一対のお人形が基本で、その他にも、一応あの男の子と女の子は、そうですね、天皇陛下と皇后様みたいになあのものをイメージしているので、それにお使いする方々だったりとか音楽を奏でる方々のお人形がくっついたりとかして少し人数を増やして飾ったりすることがもあります。で、男の子の場合はそうですね、決まりというよりかは、まあ、赤ちゃんの成長を祝って飾ればそんなに大きな決まり事はないと思います。
Yes, so for girls' dolls to be displayed for 3rd of March, they are usually displayed with in a pair. So they're a couple and one male and female dolls, and they represent almost like an emperor and empress figures. So they have their service mans and also musicians attached to them sometimes, and they are displayed all as a collection. But for boys, there aren't any strict rules. As long as it is, and the intention is to wish for their good health and healthy growth, then there aren't any strict rules.
Okay, thank you. I've got a few questions here about the dolls again specifically. So,How big are the dolls, roughly? How big are the dolls? How high are they?
お人形の高さ、そうですね。もう小さいものから大きいものまであるので決まってはいないんですが、今実演でこうお見せしたのはだいたい25センチほどになります。
Yes, so the size of dolls vary widely, and it could be anything from like very small to relatively big, but the one that I've shown you in a demonstration is around 25 centimeters in height.
Okay, thank you. And for one which is about that size, we have another question. How long does it take to make a doll that size?
皆様同じ質問をよくなさるんですが、どこから数えるのかというので全然変わってきてしまいます。というのは、お着物を織るところから、考えるのかっていうことにもなりますが、そうですね、全部合わせて一体、まあ、並行して職人が作っているんですが、それでも2ヶ月ほどはかかってしまいます。
I get that question a lot, actually. But it all depends on where you count at the start of the process is. And sometimes you count it from the making of the kimono, sometimes from the dolls. But generally speaking, it takes about 2 months to make one doll, even with a few craftsmen working alongside each other.
That's a long time. On another question of time as well, we've had a couple of questions through about how long does it take to learn how to make these dolls? How long is the apprenticeship?
そうですね。まず一番、長くかかる部分といえば、お顔を描く部分だと思います。それはそうですね。一般的にはどれぐらいかな ?5 年はかかるでしょうかね。
Yes, the longest process that you need to train as an apprentice is probably is the painting in the face, the menso process. I think in general it takes about 5 years at least.
It's a long time to devote to making the dolls, and it's absolutely beautiful. Many people are saying such beautiful work, and thank you very much for showing us your studio. We have an interesting question here. And I have a question as well. So the question from one of our viewers is, are there different types of dolls from around Japan?
そうですね、この、五月人形というのは、そうですね、いろんな種類があるかな、地域差ということで言うと多少ありますね、でも、はい。
Yes, there are...Well, these May dolls, I believe there are some regional differences, yes.
なんてご説明したらいいかちょっとわからないんですが、そうやって、もともとその武士のところで盛んに、武士の世界で盛んになったものなので、鎧を着ているものから、あとはもともとの、一番最初にお見せした、ちょっと単純な形のお人形であったりとか、あとは、宮中の方をメインにしたお人形などもあるので、さまざまな形があります。
Yes, these areThere are different varieties. It's quite difficult to explain, but one type is the one that has a tradition that wears the traditional warrior armor, or there are some more simplified forms, the one that I've shown you earlier on, the Amagetsu type of dolls, and also another one is based on the old imperial era, the Kyucho imperial palace type of dolls as well. So there are varieties of them.
Of course, yes, thank you. And my question is about the varieties that we see. I noticed that they change to fashion over time. And my question is, you know, your dolls that you're showing us at the moment are a little plump in their face, and I can see that this is something of now. My question is, how do you know about the fashion for these dolls? Does every doll maker follow the fashion, or is it particular doll makers follow a particular fashion themselves?
そうですね、流行というものは正直あまりありませんが、私どもの扱っているお人形のこうお顔がふっくらしている理由というのは、それは私の祖父が、考え出したもので、こうお人形というのは、うん、こう夜暗いところで飾っていたりするとちょっとドキッとすることがあったりするので、祖父はそのまず飾っていて怖くないお人形を作りたいって思ったのと、あとは仏像と赤ちゃんのお顔をこうミックスして、こう清らかでこうお部屋がすがすがしくなるようなお人形を目指したために、ふっくらしたお人形になりました。
Yes. Truthfully, I don't think there is that much of a fashion or trend, in terms of like how the dolls look, really. The reason why our dolls look plump in the face is because my grandfather came up with that particular look. It's because if you display dolls in the house, and especially, and if you look at them in the darkness, in the middle of the night, they could look a little scary at times. You could be a little bit surprised. Therefore, he thought of how could I make the dolls look a bit more friendly, less scary. And so he thought maybe the best way is to mix in the look of the Bodhisattva or the Buddhist figure and the face of the baby. And maybe if you mix in the two to make a softer, plumper look, that might be better. So that's why like our dolls have that particular soft look.
That's very interesting. Indeed, thank you. This whole idea of Buddha faces or Bodhisattva faces. And we have a question actually from somebody, and maybe this is the last one we can take, I'm afraid, today. Is all the dolls' faces look very peaceful. Are they smiling or are they looking brave? What is the expression that they're giving?
はい、それは、今お伝えしたその、仏像と赤ちゃんのお顔をちょうど中間にしたお顔というのを目指しているものですから、そうですね、笑っているわけでもないけれども、でまたなおかつ目もパッチリこう目が合うわけでもなく、でも見守っている、そういう感じの、お顔になっています。
Yes, I think it relates to the fact that what I have explained in my previous question and the previous question. So our face and the doll has a face of the mixture of the Buddha face as well as the face of the baby. So it's almost smiling, but it's not a wide smile. And the eyes are open, but it's not staring at you with the wide eyes. So it's somewhere in the middle with a very peacefulcalm state. So that's where you could really think what the dolls are.
It's very important, isn't it? When we were choosing dolls, which we have actually displayed at Japan House at the moment, when we chose them, the face was the most important part. And when we had a look, I said it would be the last question, but there is another one here, which I think is very interesting, just to finish.We're talking about faces. We saw the making of the clothing and the body. Do doll craftspeople, do they have to be proficient in every technique, or is there a specialty for each of the craftspeople?
はい、 そうですね。お人形というのは、先ほどもお伝えした通り、それぞれのパーツがそれぞれの職人で作っているので、私はよく建築家と同じように表現する時があります。お人形の制作を。なので、例えば一つのパーツとか全体のパーツに技術が優れているというのも、とても素晴らしい人形師の方だとは思いますが、デザインが素晴らしいというのも、とても素晴らしい人形師の方だと思っています。建築家みたいな感じで。
Yes. So I have explained that the dolls are made withvarious craftsmen throughout the process of the dolls making. So I think of it almost this, quite similar to how architects work with their teams. So it's amazing if a doll maker could take on all the process and if they are skilled in every single step. But if a doll maker is extremely talented in designing the dolls, I think that'sWonderful as well. If an architect is skilled in coming up with a wonderful design, then he would be a wonderful architect too. So that's really how I see the dolls maker work.
Thank you very much indeed. That really is all we have time for, I'm afraid. We've had so many questions. Thank you so much. And still more to answer. I do apologize if we've not been able to do it completely. So many people also saying how wonderful it is to see you at work, Hana-san. Thank you so much for sharing your time and your beautiful dolls in your studio in Tokyo with us today. That's all we have time for, I'm afraid. Thank you very much to our interpreter as well, Air Kurasawa. Thank you very much for helping us along. Just as we, before we leave, I'd like to show...everybody what we are doing at Japan House. We have a worksheet which you can download from our website from today, which will be enable you to be able to make your own koinobori, the koinobori which of course are for Children's Day for tomorrow. So please do go onto our website and have a look for those.We also have other worksheets as well, which you can download and make your own okiagari koboshi, another doll. This is a doll particularly from Fukushima Prefecture, which doesn't fall down. We also have our upcoming exhibition starting from the 17th of May at Japan House when we are able to open. That's Making Nuno, Japanese Textile Innovation from Sudo Reiko. We have another online event as well,on Friday the 14th of May. This is about Tango Chirimen. Tango is an area of Kyoto Prefecture, and this is a factory visit and conversation about Tango Chirimen, the kind of fabric made in that region. Online, you can also see our virtual exhibition, Architecture for Dogs, which you can access through our website.Many thanks for joining us today. It's been a great pleasure to be able to put this on for you. After the event, we will send you a feedback form. Please do fill it in if you could and leave a comment, and that will help us to continue in the future. Please also look up on our website for more exciting events. And once again, Hara-san, thank you very much. Thank you to you and your family. Thank you very much.From Tokyo. Thank you so much. And we look forward to seeing you hopefully, maybe in London one day, in face to face, in person. Thank you very much indeed. You take care. Please look after yourself. Thank you very much. And thank you, everybody, for watching. どうもありがとうございました。ありがとうございました。